Coronavirus is everywhere. Well, it's in the news everywhere, at least. It's continuing to spread across China and the world over, with reported cases as far as Australia and the United States. More than 60,000 people are now confirmed to have it, and over 1,300 people have died. So how worried should we really be? Has it spread to your country? Was it really caused by this thing? Can it be contained? What on earth is happening on that infected cruise ship? And can you hold your breath from now until the 1 minute 30 mark of this video? Find out why at the end of the video. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to be notified about future videos. So, number update. The current toll at the time of writing is 60,376 confirmed cases, with 1,369 deaths. Deaths per day hit a current high on Wednesday the 12th of February with 255 deaths, all from China. Outside of China, only 2 deaths have been reported overall. Of the total number of confirmed infections, nearly all have been diagnosed in China, with just under 500 coming from other countries, the highest outside of Asia being Australia, Germany, and the USA. The USA currently has 13 infected people. One interesting development is a cruise ship with 3,700 passengers has the most cases of coronavirus outside of China. The Diamond Princess has confirmed 174 people have the virus, with at least 20 of them being American. The whole ship is quarantined in Yokohama for the time being, and it accounts for a third of all new cases outside of China. Let's bring an update on its origins. The 2019 novel coronavirus has just been given its official name. Drumroll, please. It's now officially called COVID-19, or Coronavirus Disease 19. It's part of a larger family of viruses, also known as coronaviruses, that cause illness, which could be in the form of a cold or more serious respiratory disease. The word corona in Latin means crown, and is used as the virus has crown-like projections on its protein shell that encases its genetic material. Other coronaviruses include the SARS virus and MERS virus. There has been a widely discredited theory about it being snake flu, and also one conspiracy theory from Russia's Channel 1 linking it to Donald Trump and US intelligence or pharmaceutical companies. But disregarding these bat-crazy theories, the research is starting to point to this. Coronaviruses are zoonotic, which means they spread between animals and humans. SARS was spread by bats to civet cats to humans, and MERS from dromedary camels to humans. Researchers in China have suggested that this Pokemon Sandshrew…
Who's that Pokemon?
Oops, sorry, I meant this scaly ant-eating mammal called a pangolin is the likely source of the new virus outbreak. This cute-looking thing is actually the most trafficked animal in the world, unfortunately. Humans really are jerks, eh? They count for around 20% of illegal wildlife trade. This is because in some parts of Asia, their meat is considered a delicacy, and in traditional Chinese medicine, their scales are thought to neutralize witchcraft and evil spirits, and treat ailments such as skin diseases, menstrual disorders, and arthritis, even though their scales are made out of keratin, just like human hair. Chinese law states that people selling pangolins can be punished by 10 years or more in prison, yet it still happens. The virus's genetic sequence has been found in pangolins, and is 99% similar to that found in humans. It's thought that the original host of the virus is from bats, with the pangolin as a carrier host that could have caught the virus if bat feces, aka guano, or saliva came into contact with food that's consumed by a pangolin. The virus emerged in the Chinese city of Wuhan, and is thought to have spread to humans from a seafood and wild animal market in the city, where many of the first humans became infected. This could have been from pangolin meat or excrement. Okay, so how does it infect you? The virus is concentrated in the respiratory route, or the nose and lungs. A human with the virus can pass it on via droplets from sneezing, coughing, or exhaling, just like the flu. But unlike the flu, there is no current vaccine. How deadly is it really? It's far from the apocalyptic impending doom for humanity unless we stop it now that mainstream news would make us believe.
Just think what might have happened if we didn't tell everyone about the monster!
About the what?
It is serious, yes. The 60,000 cases documented is probably far higher, as people with minor symptoms would not have been diagnosed. But with that, the mortality rate of 2% would go down further. To put it into context, the flu has a yearly mortality rate of under 1%, killing 400,000 people a year. And the SARS outbreak in 2002 to 2003 had a death rate of over 10% and killed 774 people. Previous strains of the virus and similar viruses are more common in winter months, and it's hoped with warmer weather, cases will also drop. Symptoms. Symptoms are akin to the cold and flu, with the most common being fever, fatigue, a dry cough, muscle pain, and difficulty breathing. In more severe cases, it can cause pneumonia, severe acute respiratory syndrome, and kidney failure. People who are ending up in hospital are usually those with a lower immune system, generally people over 40. Most people's immune systems are strong enough to fight off the virus, but the people dying are normally older and have underlying health problems that weakens their immune system and they're unable to fight off the virus. How it's treated? There is no cure, just like the flu, and rest, hydration, and over-the-counter painkillers is all you can do. Precautions. Standard infection preventions apply. Regular hand washing, avoiding warm cuddles and close contact with anyone showing serious symptoms. A face mask is recommended in highly infected areas, and if you don't have one and someone coughs, hold your breath and run away until your face turns purple. So how long did you or can you hold your breath for then? Really that long? Well, we just wanted to test you really, and we're ever so proud. Go you! Leave a comment with how long it was. Winner gets a penguin in the post. Make sure you hit subscribe and the bell icon now. Leave a like to get the video shown to a wider audience. And thank you, science is beautiful. Viruses and fake news are not. Love you!